大家好，欢迎你嚟到优秀移民，我系李生，我系专门同你讲关于移民最优秀嘅地方。今日我想介绍下南美洲西班牙国家嘅房地产。首先要讲清楚，我唔系卖房地产嘅人嚟嘅，所以呢，我喺呢个片里边讲所有嘅嘢呢，唔系为咗我自己嘅利益嘅。OK，咁就系呢，咁移民西班牙文国家有乜嘢咁好呢？個物價比較低啲，咁咧10萬美元咧喺西班牙文國家都可以買到房地產嘅。我亦都唔建議任何人去一個陌生地方買房地產，我只係會介紹所有人首先就去租，了解嗰個地方嘅情況，了解個文化，學嗰啲外語，然之後再決定租嘅。唔係，然後先決定買嘅。咁咧，其實就西班牙文國家咧，就有一個好處，就係因為嗰啲房地產平咧，你就無需要一大筆嘅現金攞過去嘅。咁基本上你每個月嗰個租金都好平嘅。咁咧喺我哋睇四個國家咧，一個就墨西哥，一個就係哥倫比亞、智利同埋阿根廷。咁喺四個國家裏邊咧，基本上10萬美元都係買得到噶。咁如果你按照10萬美元呢個價錢咧，每年嘅租金係大概3000至4000美元嘅。咁所以你就無需要攞一筆大嘅資金過去嘅，你只需要每個月3至4000蚊美元啊，咁你就可以喺嗰度租一個房嘅。好啦，咁我睇第一個國家，第一個國家就係墨西哥，OK？墨西哥呢個咧就係10萬美元嘅，就係777平方尺一個房間同埋一個廁所嘅。咁呢個單位咧就位於墨西哥嘅東部，呢度治安比較好嘅，因為係遊客區嚟嘅。咁第二個單位咧就係哥倫比亞啦，哥倫比亞呢個亦都係10萬美元嘅。呢個就1000平方尺，兩個廁所嘅，係新樓嚟嘅。呢個就位於哥倫比亞第二大城市 Medellin。好啦，第三個單位就係智利啦。智利呢間係一個二手屋嚟嘅，就係有兩個房間睡房，一個廁所。就係53平方米咧，咁呢個係大概700平方尺左右嘅，第四個單位就係阿根廷喺呢個首都嗰個外郊嗰度嘅，呢個亦都唔需要10萬美元嘅，呢個係一個廁所一個睡房，473平方尺嘅，係樓嚟嘅。好啦，睇完咗咁多樓之後，咁你又可能問翻我轉頭點解要移民去西班牙文國家？因為移民去係完全係冇條件嘅，你只需要證明你每個月有個被動收入，佢基本上就係唔會拒絕你嘅。咁啊，我就喜歡去西班牙文國家，就因為我自己本人就喜歡學外語嘅。咁我覺得去一個西班牙文國家住都 OK，反正都識講英文，咁亦都冇需要。去再去學英文，我反而覺得退休生活學個新語言對我嚟講，亦都有一個好處。第二就去到一個平地方就唔需要工作，只需要快樂。另外就係咧如果你係咯，即係如果你係退休人士，咁你其實去一個貴嘅國家住，亦都係冇癮嘅。又貴，同埋我喜歡南美洲國家，因為佢天氣係比北美洲熱啲嘅。咁喺北美洲裏邊咧，除咗美國個南部之外咧，其餘嘅地方都係比較凍噶啦。咁我就唔係咁受到凍天氣嘅。咁另外一個問題就係好多人會認為啊，學西班牙文咧就難唔難？我本人就覺得唔難，因為我有個英文嘅基礎。咁我就唔係咁認真學西班牙文嘅，我係一個星期學一次嘅啫，而且上網有好多好嘅網站學，咁但係我學咧，你可以睇到接下嚟呢個片段咧，咁我講4.5分鐘西班牙文嘅，基本上同英文係差唔多嘅，我亦都唔會點錯嘅，基本嘅溝通咧我都得嘅。 咁我就目前嚟講咧就冇乜資格去教西班牙文。不過遲啲啊，遲啲可能考慮呢個問題。但係如果你有問題關於接下嚟嗰個片段裏面嗰啲西班牙文咧，我都可以回答到你嘅。因為基本上基本現在識嘅嘢咧就唔係咁難嘅。好啦，咁你咪睇睇我自己學西班牙文嗰個程度啦，快唔快咯？如果你本身係學西班牙文嘅，你可能覺得以下嘅片段亦都係有趣嘅。
Fuero. Again.
Usar.
Usar. And how do you say to use it?
Usarlo.
Usarlo. Now try to say, I'm going to demonstrate how to use it.
Voy a demostrar cómo usarlo.
Voy a demostrar cómo usarlo. The word properly is often interchangeable in English with the word correctly.
Correctamente.
Because you can say, I'm going to show you how to use it properly, or to show you how to use it correctly. Now, in Spanish, they use this word correctly. So it would be correctamente.
Correctamente.
Because you have a double R here, and so it's good to try to roll your R at that point. Correctamente.
Correctamente.
If you can't roll your R, or you need more practice, don't worry too much about it. You'll still be understood. But just be aware that you should be trying to roll that correctamente.
Correctamente.
So they use this word meaning properly. How would you say, I'm going to demonstrate how to use it properly?
Voy a demostrar cómo usarlo correctamente.
Voy a demostrar cómo usarlo correctamente. To investigate in Spanish would be
investigar.
Investigar. Investigar. How would you say we're going to investigate?
Vamos a investigar.
Vamos a investigar. How do you say what happened?
¿Qué pasó?
¿Qué pasó? Now try to say, we're going to investigate what happened yesterday.
Vamos a investigar qué pasó ayer.
Vamos a investigar. ¿Qué pasó ayer? How would you say, I don't know what happened?
No sé qué pasó.
No sé qué pasó. Now say, I don't know what happened, but I'm going to investigate.
No sé qué pasó, pero voy a investigar.
No sé qué pasó. Pero voy a investigar. How do you say you can or can you?
Puedes.
Puedes. Now let's ask a question. How would you ask, can you investigate what happened, please?
Puedes investigar qué pasó, por favor.
Puedes investigar qué pasó, por favor. In this sense, you can see that the verb investigar can mean to investigate, but also a sense of can you find out? So, can you find out what happened or can you investigate what happened? Puedes investigar. Verb number 8 is to accept.
Aceptar.
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 Aceptar. How would you say to accept it?
Aceptarlo.
Aceptarlo. Just as always, you hook the lo, standing for it, onto the end of the full verb. So we get aceptarlo.
Aceptarlo.
Try to say, I can't accept it.
No puedo aceptarlo.
No puedo accettarlo。
好啦，睇完我片段之后，你哋觉得点呢？你系对西班牙文国家或者西班牙文有乜嘢问题？你可以后边留下边留言俾我。多谢你收看。